Paracletus International Ministries encourages you to excel in Christ daily.
I think about how I ran from the ministry for so many years. I ran from pastoring for so many years. Amen. My heart wasn't there.
Yeah.
My heart wasn't there. And so I can see Jude saying, you know, I got this present in my heart to write something, but I really don't want to write it. But one day Jude says, I gave in and I became diligent to write.
Yeah.
I made my mind up. I sold myself out. I'm going to write this. Why, Jude? Because verse 1 says, Jude, the servant of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
You're saying, I'm not my own. I don't own myself.
Yes.
So he's telling me, I'm his servant. He's saying, right. So now I'm going to line up and do what he says. I'm going to become diligent in this thing. I'm going to work hard for it. I'm going to put forth my every effort to write unto you. He said, I want to write to you about the common salvation. But when I became sold out to God, when I became diligent about doing this, something else came up in my spirit.
Yeah.
And I realized it was needful for me to write unto you and exhort you that you should earnestly contend for the faith.
Mm-hmm.
Earnestly contend.
Yeah.
When you realize who you are in God.
Yeah.
And you realize what God has done for you.
Yeah.
Amen. I was singing a song, Oh the Blood. Oh, the blood will never lose the power. When you realize what God has done for you and God bought you from and what God bought you through, and you realize all the things that you've been facing in life and how God bought you through all those things,
mm-hmm.
you got to contend for the faith.
Yeah.
You know, and as I think about this message on Thursday night, I think it was Thursday night, I began to look at this. And I thought about my life, how Satan laid breadcrumbs in my way. He laid breadcrumbs. He knew my desire to work with computers. So he put breadcrumbs in my way.
Mm.
Got me into school so I could learn about operating systems and learn about networking and learn about servers and learn about the different things and aspects of computers. He would put a breadcrumb. And I'm following that breadcrumb. And then he got me to the point where I got a job working in the computer field. Amen. I had a teacher who was my teacher. Amen. Came and said to me, Julius, I can't give you a job. But what I can do is give you an opportunity. You come here and work for us. Then you can use this on your resume. And it'll open doors for you. And I went and worked for that company. That was another breadcrumb. Get me away into what the devil wanted me to go and not where God wanted me to go.
All right.
So I got jobs working in computers, worked in computers, taught computer classes, breadcrumbs. Satan just kept laying his breadcrumbs in front of me. And I kept following them. Mm-hmm. Now, if you had asked me, Julius, are you still beloved of God? I would say, yes, I am. You said to me, Julius, do you still love God? Yes, I do.
Mm-hmm.
Julius, are you still faithful to God? Yes, I am.
Yeah.
But I'm following these breadcrumbs. And I didn't realize that I was going in the opposite direction.
Uh-huh.
See, let me tell you something. The word sin doesn't mean adultery.
All right.
The word sin doesn't mean fornication. The word sin doesn't mean stealing. The word sin means to miss the mark. And when you commit adultery or fornicate or lie or whatever you do, those are the symptoms of your sin.
Yeah.
So if Satan gets you to missing the mark, he don't have to get you into drugs.
Yeah.
Just get you to missing the mark.
Yeah.
He ain't got to get you on alcohol. Just get you to missing the mark. He ain't got to get you on this and that and the other. Just get you to missing the mark. And so he laid those breadcrumbs. And I'm following those breadcrumbs.
Yeah.
Following those breadcrumbs.
Yeah.
Thinking I'm hitting the target.
Mm-hmm.
going in that direction, following the breadcrumbs, but the target was back here.
Yeah.
And so I'm following the breadcrumbs, target back here. I'm following the breadcrumbs.
Yeah.
Doing things in church, following the breadcrumbs. Being on different organizations in the church, following the breadcrumbs. But yet, the mark was back here. I was not hitting the mark because I was following the breadcrumbs away from the mark.
Yeah.
Following the breadcrumbs away from the mark.
Yeah.
And so what I had to do was turn around and look in the direction of the mark.
Yeah.
Since sin is missing the mark, and I'm following the breadcrumbs, I'm going away from the mark, I had to turn around and go in the direction of the mark.
Yeah.
Now the problem is that the mark was so far away because I followed those breadcrumbs and got so far from the mark.
Yeah.
See, I was not drinking alcohol. Mm-hmm. I was not cussing. I was not hanging in the clubs. I was not doing those different things, but I was still missing the mark because my mark was to do what God said do, and I wasn't doing it because I was following the breadcrumbs, thinking that I'm going right when I was going wrong. But now, when I turned and I realized that the mark is a long ways off, now I got to press. As Paul said in Philippians, I got to press toward the mark of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. I had to turn that direction and go going in the right direction.
Yeah.
Amen. And it's taking me a while to get to where I need to be. So that when I throw, I can hit the target.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm headed in the right direction now.
Yeah.
Headed in the right direction. And I'm going to think about the message. And I thought about what God did to make us beloved, to put us in that place of esteem. One definition of esteem is prestige. Put us in that place of prestige. Put us in that place of honor. Put us in that place of endearment. When I got to thinking about that, I got to thinking, I said, Julius, is all of this mm-hmm. worth the beloved?
Yeah.
If the faith more important to me than my dreams mm-hmm. and my aspirations and my desires. You see, my cousin, when she went to Detroit when I was 11 years old, she came back and told us how computers were. Amen. And it put a burden in my heart to work with computers. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to work with computers. Mm-hmm. Amen. That's what I desired to work.
Mm-hmm.
But now the question was, is the faith more important than my dreams? Is the faith more important?